Hello everyone and welcome to Popcorn Anatomy. My name is Ursula and I don't know about you, but I just finished watching season 4 of Orange is the New Black, and not only do I feel like there's this giant hole in my heart now, but holy crap, that cliffhanger is even worse than the last one. At least season 3 ended with it being obvious how Alex was gonna come out of that shed alive, so much so that I actually predicted it in my last video about Orange is the New Black, so you can check that out if you haven't yet. So season 4 made us say goodbye to some of our favorite characters towards the end, and it definitely was the saddest season out of them all, but it's a cliffhanger we're really going to focus on today. As you know, season 4 ends with there being this giant riot because Theo Bailey is pronounced innocent by Caputo. This makes Theo Humphrey pull out his gun, obviously, and it is then knocked out of his hand, and Daya grabs it, but then the episode ends, and now we need to wait till next year to find out whether or not she actually pulls the trigger. Obviously, we won't be able to tell for sure what's going to happen right now. Our theories can't be confirmed until season 5 actually comes out and we see it for ourselves. But right now, it does seem safe to come up with a prediction, a hypothesis if you may, of what's gonna happen. And my hypothesis is, no. Daya does not shoot. I compiled all the circumstantial evidence I have to reassure you. First off, if Daya were to shoot the guard, it would change the mood of the entire television series for several reasons. I decided to look at the different patterns between seasons and come up with the following conclusions. Obviously, the show is both a drama and a comedy, and we see elements of both genres present in all seasons. However, last season was predominantly a drama. Yes, there were funny moments, but overall, it was the saddest season out of them all. And I think it's safe to say that the second most dramatic season was season 2, meaning seasons 1 and 3 were a lot lighter than the rest. If this pattern continues, then it would mean season 5 would have to be at least somewhat happier than season 4 was, and you don't have a happy season if Daya gets sent to Shu, Max, or Psych for the rest of her life, and her mother's back at home having this existential crisis wondering where she went wrong and raising her daughter. Another thing I noticed is that with the exception of season 4, none of the seasons continued exactly where the last one left off. Let me explain this a little better. You remember how season 1 ended, right? Piper beats the crap out of Pensatuckee. Season 2 doesn't begin with the same scene though. It begins sometime later with Piper getting moved to a different facility. Season 2 ends with two of the inmates escaping. That's when Rosa kills V. Again, season 3 doesn't pick up right when season 2 left off. Season 4 was the only one that picked up with the same scene as season 3, but that's because season 4 was a turning point for the entire series, involving all of this drama collected from all the past seasons. I'm really gonna go out on a limb now and say that there's a good chance season 5 won't pick up right where season 4 left off then, because the majority of the time that has not happened. If that's the case, then there's a good chance Daya doesn't murder anyone, because what's the point in having a plot twist that major if we don't actually see it happening? Now there's also a good chance that season 4 set the trend for years to come, and that from now on, each season will continue where the last one left off. But even then, we have more evidence as to why Daya doesn't shoot. Let's talk a little more about the character herself now. While Daya may not be completely innocent, she's still a good person, too good to really hurt anyone. She decides to get revenge on her mom by doing something she'll never find out about, because she doesn't dare to face her herself. She gets Pornstache in trouble, only to save herself and her boyfriend, and when Pornstache gets accused of having raped her, she comes clean twice and says he didn't do it. And that's not even all. If you remember clearly, Daya has always been too much of a good girl to even get involved in prison drama. She didn't help get Sophia thrown in the shoe, and she never joined Piper's panty business. She never actually helped Maria sell drugs either. She's never gotten into trouble with an inmate who's risen to power, and she's done a good job of staying out of everyone's business and hasn't gotten in trouble once, and she feels enormous guilt when she does something wrong. So what makes you think she'll suddenly get a change of heart and kill someone? She also has a daughter to take care of, so trust me when I say she doesn't want any more years added to her sentence. The last reason I think Daya won't kill Theo Humphrey is because of what she said before she cocked the gun. If I remember correctly, her exact words are,
"Hey lady, Theo, get on the phone with your hands behind your head, right now. Before I shoot your little friend here in the eyeball."
It sounds more like she wants to be in control and threaten them to stop the abuses that have been going on in Litchfield since the old guards left. That's a warning, and she cocks the gun to scare them to death, not to actually shoot Humphreys. But even if her intent is to shoot, there are simply too many things that are bound to stop her. It could be another inmate like Gloria, or it could be an authority figure, or even the media coverage going on nearby. She could even miss, who knows? Although that seems pretty unlikely. Anyway, all we can do is wait until season 5 to find out whether or not Daya pulls the trigger. This may all be circumstantial evidence, but when you put it all together, it wouldn't really make sense for her to murder a guard. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to Popcorn Anatomy for more theories on the upcoming season of Orange is the New Black, and about all your favorite shows and movies. We upload new stuff every week, so see you soon on Popcorn Anatomy.